గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ వాళ్ళకు. సో టుడే టాపిక్ ఈజ్ ట్రీస్. సో ఇన్ ది సెషన్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ట్రీస్ అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ట్రీస్, వాట్ ఆర్ ఇట్స్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ అండ్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ట్రీస్. ఓకే, సో డెఫినిషన్, ఎ ట్రీ ఈజ్ ఏ సింపుల్ గ్రాఫ్ జి సచ్ దట్ there is a unique simple undirected graph between each pair of vertices in G. So in other words, the tree is a simple graph without having any circuit, without having any circuit, or tree is a connected acyclic graph. Connected acyclic, acyclic means having no cycles, having no cycles. Okay, tree is a connected acyclic graph. So acyclic means having no cycles. So tree is a connected graph without any circuit. So what is the definition of tree? Tree is a connected graph without any circuit. Okay, so let us consider a graph shown in figure. So here it is a graph with no circuits. So there is a path from one vertex to another vertex, and there is no repetition of paths to between two vertices, and there is no self loops, and there is no cycle in this graph. So it is a tree. So this is also example for tree. So here A to C path, and C to B, and C to E, and C to D. So here also there is no cycle and there is no circuit in this graph. So it is an example for tree. Okay, so this is also, so A, B, C, D, E, F. So A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, D E to F. Here also there is no circuit and there is no any self loops. Okay, this is a simple graph. A tree is a simple graph without having any circuit. Okay, so A to B, A to C, B to D, B to E, and C to F. This is also an example for tree. So in this example, it has a circuit, cycle. So A to B, B to D, D to C, C to A. So this is not an example for tree because it has a cycle. So A to B, B to D, D to C, C to A. So what is tree? The tree is a simple graph without having any cycle or without having any loop or circuit. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4 graphs are examples for trees, but fifth graph is not an example for tree because it has a cycle. Okay, so some properties of trees. A pendant vertex of a tree is also called a leaf. And so this graph, it is not a tree because it forms a cycle. So here it represents a cycle, so it is not yet an example for tree. Okay, next, in a tree there is one and only one path between every pair of vertices. There is only one and only one path between every pair of, so here E to F there is a one path, E to D there is a one path. So in a tree there is one and only one path between every pair of vertices. So a tree with n vertices have n minus 1 edges. A tree with n vertices have n minus 1 edges. So if we consider this graph, so here how many vertices are there? 6 vertices. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So How many edges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it has 6 vertices and it has 5 edges. This means a tree has n vertices and with n minus 1 edges. How? N minus 1 edges. So any connected graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges is also called tree. A connected graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges is also a tree. Okay. So a connected graph is said to be minimally connected. A connected graph is said to be minimally connected if the removal of any edge from that graph, it becomes disconnected graph. Okay. So if we remove this edge, so E2F edge, we remove this edge, it becomes a disconnected graph. So either we consider this graph, if we remove C2D edge, this is also called bridge of the graph. So if we remove this edge, it becomes disconnected graph. So any connected graph is said to be minimally connected if the removal of an edge and any one edge, the removal of any one edge from that graph becomes disconnected. Okay. Next one, rooted tree. Rooted tree. So a rooted tree is a tree in which a particular vertex is distinguished as the root or designated as the root. That is the starting node of the tree or vertex of the tree. Okay. So a rooted tree is a tree in which a particular vertex is distinguished as the root node. That is also called starting node. Okay. So if we draw a rooted tree, this is the rooted tree. So in this, every node in a graph having some children, every node in a graph having some children. So here we distinguished A is the root node. For this particular root, parent of D and E is B. Parent node of D and E is B. And A is ancestor node for D and E. A is ancestor. Ancestor means higher than parent node. Higher than parent node is called ancestor. So D and E, the parent of D and E is B, and ancestor node of D and E is A. Okay. So what is ancestor? Higher than parent node is called ancestor. And D and E is said to be descendant of root node A. Descendant of root node A. So in this, another one is sibling. So sibling means having same parent. If we talk about B and C, B and C have same parent, that is A. So B and C are called siblings. B and C are called siblings. Okay. E and F are not siblings because their parents are different. So E is the child for B and F is child for C. So here E and F are not siblings, but B and C are siblings. Their parent is A. Okay. So in this graph, D, E, G are called leaf nodes. D, E, G are called leaf nodes. So leaf nodes are those nodes do not have any child. So what is leaf node? The leaf node is those nodes do not have any child. Those called leaf node. Okay, those nodes are called leaf node. So in this rooted tree, D, E, G are leaf nodes. Okay. Between leaf node and root node, remaining all nodes are called interior nodes. Okay. Between leaf node and root node. Between leaf node and root node are called interior nodes or interval or terminal nodes under. Okay, na? So in this rooted tree, B, C, F are interior nodes. B, C, F are interior nodes. Okay. So in this one more thing is level of the rooted node. So if we I talk about the level of this tree, then we always put the level from root node. So the root node is in level 0. Okay. And interior nodes are in level 1. And these nodes are in level 2. Okay. And G is in level 3. This is how we find level of the rooted tree. So put the level from root node, starts with level 0 and level 1, level 2, level 3. Okay. So next one is height of the rooted node, rooted tree. Height of the rooted tree. So how we find a height of the root node? Then we define height is length of longest path between root to any leaf node. Root node to any leaf node means if we talk about a rooted tree, in this leaf node is D, E, G. Okay, so the longest path between root node to these leaf nodes. So in this leaf nodes are D, E, G. So A to B, B to D. So level 2. Okay. So the longest path from root node to leaf node is A to G. So A to C, C to F and F to G. So the longest path from root node to leaf node is A to G. So the level of that leaf node is 3. So the height of this tree is 3. Okay. So longest path means the total number of edges we cross while traversing the root. Okay. The longest path from root node to leaf node, it gives the height of the rooted tree. So longest path means the total number of edges we across the while traversing. Okay. So in this rooted tree, the how to find height of the this rooted tree, the longest path from root node A to a leaf node G is 3. Okay. So next one, next definition, binary tree. So binary means 2. Okay, binary means 2. So binary tree. So a rooted tree is called a binary tree if every internal vertex of T is of out degree 1 or 2. That is, if every vertex has at most 2 children. At most 2 children and possible children are either 0, 1 or 2. At most. Okay. So a rooted tree is called a binary tree if every internal vertex of internal vertex means interior node. Every interior node of the tree is of degree 1 or 2. That is, if every vertex has at most 2 children, a tree have 0, 1, 2 at maximum children, whether it is right side or left side. Okay. So we consider, let us consider the following graph. So in this graph, V1, V2, so if we consider V5, so V5 has no children, so 0, okay? And V6 is also has no children, so this degree is 0. And V3 has 2 children, V5, V6, so it is 2. And V1 has 1 children, that is V3, and V2 has 1 children, V4, and V7 has 2 children, V8, V9, and V8 has no children, so this value is 0, this degree is 0, and V9 has no children, this degree is also 0. So every node of this graph has either 0, 1, 2. So the condition, 0 condition is satisfied, and the main thing is the interior nodes of degree at most 2 children only. So this is the example for binary tree. Okay. So next definition, directed tree. A rooted tree is a directed tree if there is a root from, there is a root from which there is a directed path to each vertex of the tree. So directed tree means if there is a root from which there is a directed path to each vertex. So A to B, B to E, and E to D, G, E to H, and A to C, A to D. These are the directed path to each vertex of the tree. So D to F. So A to F, there is a path. A to D, D to F, and A to C, there is a path from root. So A to B, B to E, and E to G, E to H. So this is the example for directed tree. Next, one more important topic is spanning tree. Okay. So a tree is called a spanning tree of connected graph G if T is subgraph of G and T contains all the vertices of G. So what is spanning tree? If T is a subgraph of a given graph and that subgraph has all vertices of given graph, then it is called spanning tree of G. Okay. So if we consider subgraph of given graph, that subgraph of also has all vertices of G. So that graph is called spanning tree. Okay. So if we consider an example, so A to B, B to C, A to B, B to C, D, E. So here, how many vertices are there? 5 vertices. And how many edges? So number of edges is equal to number of vertices minus 1. So here, how many vertices are there? 5 vertices. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of edges is equal to number of vertices minus 1. So determine all the spanning trees of the following graph. So the given graph is A, B, C, D. So the given graph is A, B, C, D. So the spanning graph of, spanning tree of, so this is spanning tree because here A to B, C to D. Okay. So A to B, A to D, C. This is subgraph of a given graph. and A to B, B to C, C to D. And this graph has all vertices of given graph, and it is a subgraph of a given graph. Spanning tree. Okay. So this is given graph. You need to write spanning trees of this graph. So tree means there is no loop and there is only one path between any pair of vertices. So here A to B, A to D, D to C. This is spanning tree. It is a tree and it is spanning tree because all vertices of given graph considering in this graph, in this tree. Okay, A to B, C to D. So A to D, C to B, A to B, C to D. So C to A, B, C and D, C, B, A. These are the spanning trees of given graph. Okay. So in next example, V1, V2, V3, V4. So spanning tree of this graph is V1, V2, V3, V4. So these are the spanning trees of given graph. So every tree has all vertices of the given graph and there is no any loops and any circuits. So these are the examples for spanning trees. Okay. So next one, algorithms for spanning trees. So here first one is breadth first search and depth first search. So BFS method and DFS method. So in BFS method means breadth first search. So in this algorithm, a rooted tree is constructed and the underlying undirected graph for this rooted tree forms the spanning tree. So the rooted tree is constructed and the given rooted tree, we find the spanning tree using breadth first search. So the procedure for BFS is, first one, in first step, choose a vertex arbitrarily and designate it as the root. In first step, choose a vertex arbitrarily and designate it as the root. Okay. In next step, second step, add all the edges incident at that vertex. Add all the edges incident to its vertex such that the addition of edges does not produce any cycle. So that vertex do not produce any cycle. Okay. So the new vertices added at this stage become the vertices at level 1 in the spanning tree. Order them in an arbitrary manner. Okay. So first step is choose a root vertex. In second step, add all the edges incident that vertex. So that vertex, the edges are not produce circuits or any cycle. Okay. So next, in third step, for each vertex at level 1 visited in order and add each edge incident to this vertex to the tree as long as it does not produce any cycle. So next, in fourth step, continue in this process until all these vertices in the graph had been added. Thus we can form as spanning tree. So in this way we proceed. We continue the process until all the vertices in the given rooted graph had been added. Thus, we can form a spanning tree. Okay. So, in DFS method, this algorithm gives the procedure to successive levels in a tree of the earliest possible opportunity. So, DFS is also called backtracking method. Okay. So, in this, first step is choose a vertex from the vertices of the graph and designate it as a root. So from a path starting at this vertex, by successively adding edges as long as possible. Okay. Where each new edge is incident with the last vertex in the path without producing any cycle. So second step lo first manam edaithe vertex ni root vertex ga consider chestunnamo aa vertex nundi a path starting at that vertex by successively adding edges. So a to b, b to c, c to d, d to e, we add those edges successively. Okay, where each new edge is incident with the last vertex in the path, so those edges are not giving any cycle. So until that we add the edges to starting vertex successively. Okay, if the path goes through all vertices of the graph, then the tree consisting of this path is a spanning tree. If manam start chesina path nundi graph lo unna all vertices ki continuous ga path velthunte manamu aa vertex ni root vertex ga consider chestamu. Otherwise cycle form avutunte another vertex ni root vertex ga consider chesi akkada nundi path continue chestam. Okay na? So until the all the vertices of the given graph had been added to the graph. So final la manam em find out cheyali spanning tree. Spanning tree ante enti? Subgraph of the given graph and it has all the vertices, that graph doesn't have any cycles. Okay, so move back to the next vertex in the path. If possible, form a new path starting at this vertex, passing through vertices that were not already visited. So ikkada fourth step lo em cheptunnarante, so if suppose manam consider chesina first vertex nundi without any cycle forming manam anni vertices ki path unte manam age continue avtam. Otherwise ekkadaina cycle form avutunte akkada tho stop chesi manamu another vertex ni root ga consider chestam until next remaining vertices ki path so if this cannot be done move back another vertex in the path and repeat the process as in step 2 so continue in this process until a spanning tree obtain. Okay, so problem chudandi ardham avutundi. Find the spanning tree by using spanning graph by using BFS and DFS algorithm for the following graph. So the given graph is shown here. So v1, v2, v7, v5, v3, v3, v6, v8, so v4. So ichina graph ki manamu spanning tree find out cheyali using BFS and DFS algorithm. So first we consider BFS algorithm. So BFS algorithm lo first step enti, consider a vertex v1. We designate a vertex as a root node. So in this consider v1 as a root node in v1 and insert v1 in q. So in step 1 we consider v1. So in second step add all the edges incident at that vertex. So all the edges, so v1 to v2, v1 to v6, v1 to v4, v1 to v3, these are all incident at v1. So v1 to v2, v1 to v3 and v1 to v6, v1 to v4. So add all the edges incident to the vertex v1 such that the addition of edges does not form any cycle. Okay, hence the edges v1 v2 v1 v3 v1 v4 v1 v6 are added. So these are the edges incident at v1. In next step, so v1 ki anni edges add chesam, next manamu delete v1 from q. So next we assign v2 as a root. Now the vertices are v2, v3, v6, v4. So we consider v2 in q. Okay, so then add edges of edges incident at v2. So in the figure, incident edges at v2 is v1 to V1, V7. So V1 to V2 is already existed in before step. So we need not to show again. So we take V2, V7 edge. Okay. V2, V7 edge. So V2, V7. So in next step, consider. So the all edges incident at V2 is completed. Next, we take V7 as in Q. Okay, consider V7 in Q. Next, we add edges incident at V7. Okay, so here V7 edges, the edges incident at V7 is V5 to V7 and V7 to V3. If we take the edge V7 to V3, it gives a cycle. So we do not show the edge V7 to V3 because it forms a cycle. So we take V7 to V5 edge only. So V7 to V5. Okay. So next, all the edges incident at V7 is completed. So V5 has no edges. Next, we consider V4 as the as in Q. So the edges incident at V4 is V8. Okay. So we draw V8. So if we consider V3 vertex, then we form a cycle. So then V3 deleted from Q. Consider vertex V4, attached the edge V4, V8 to tree. Okay. So V4 to V8. So if we consider V8 as in Q, the edge incident at V8 is V4 and V6. V4 is already exist and we draw V6, it becomes cycle. So V8 is deleted from Q. So therefore, a spanning tree. So if we check here, all the vertices of given graph is appear in this graph. So V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7. So this is spanning tree of a given graph. Okay, if we consider V8 vertex, we form a cycle. Hence, V8 is deleted from Q. So therefore, a spanning tree that consists of edges V1, V2, V1, V3, V1, V4, V1, V6, V2, V7, V7, V5, V4, V8 has been determined. So hence, the BFS spanning tree is, this is here. So this is the BFS spanning tree. Okay. So first we consider V1 is in Q and next we draw edges incident at V1. So V4, V6, V3 and V2. In next step we consider V2 is in Q. The edges incident at V2 is V7, V1. V1 is already exist. So we draw V7. Next we consider V7 as in Q. So the edges incident at V7 are V3 and V5. So here we draw V3, it gives a closed cycle. So we remove this edge. We didn't take that edge. So V7 to V5. So V5 has no incident edges. So we go to V3. If we take V3 is in Q, it gives cycle. So we delete V3 from Q. So next we go to V4. So V4, the edges incident at V4 is V1 to V4 and V1 to V8. V1 to V4 is already exist. So V4 to V8. Okay, next we consider V8 is in Q. So the edges incident at V8 is V4 and V6. If we take an edge to V6, it gives a cycle. So we remove this edge. So this is the spanning tree of BFS. Okay. So BFS spanning tree. So this graph has, this tree has all the vertices of the given graph and it is spanning tree. Okay. This is how we find BFS spanning tree. So next, DFS algorithm. So check DFS algorithm in step one. DFS algorithm for same graph. Okay. Consider the vertex V1 to be a root. So V1 to be a root, that is initial vertex. So next, consider the edge V1 to V2 and attach to T. So V1 to V2, there is an edge. So V1 to V2. Consider V2. If now V2 is the initial vertex, now add V2 to V7 and attach the edge V2 V7 to 7. Next, V7 is the initial vertex. Add, attach the edge V7 to V5. V7 to V3 to 3. Okay. So, V7 to V3. Next, we consider V3 as initial vertex. Then, we find a cycle. So, then V3 is deleted from Q. And consider V7 as the initial vertex. And attach the edge V5 to 3. So, that gives V7 to V5. Okay, so go back to V1 because V5 has no any edge. So go back to V1 and attach the edge V1 to V4 to 3. So V1 to V4. So continue this process, attach the edges V4 to V8. Okay, V8 to V6. So V4 to V8 and V8 to V6. This is the DFS spanning tree. So here all the vertices of the given graph is appear, and this is the DFS spanning tree. Okay, thus the spanning tree has the vertices V1, V2, V2, V7, V7, V3, V7, V5, V1, V4, V7, V8, V8, V6 has been determined. So hence the DFS spanning tree is V1, V2. So first we take V1 as the initial vertex and attach the edge V1 to V2. Next, V2 as the initial vertex, attach the edge V7. And V7 as the initial vertex, attach the edge V7, V3. So, if we take V3 as the initial vertex, the edge gives the cycle. So, next go back to V7 and attach the edge V5. Okay. So, next in go, there is no edge from V5. So, we go to V1 is an initial vertex here. So we attach the edge V1 to V4. Now V4 is an initial vertex and we attach the edge V4 to V8. And V8 is initial vertex. We attach the edge V6. This is the DFS spanning tree. So this is how you find spanning tree for using DFS and BFS method for given graph. Okay. Thank you.